to your broadcast, I know. I'm good at letting go. And then take me along with your rules, with your promise, I swear. You spend too much time.
You watch me grow up from a boy. I watched you build from what's destroyed. Rehabbing houses but held grudges when my mom's house wasn't yours. She had to build some of her own. We disagree on right and wrong. Been on and off communicating since the day I left from home. And as we get older, it's hard to reach understanding. I left for no plan B. Yeah, I could be all around the world, but with our family, it don't mean anything.
Can we bring the love back? I know that you've been waiting so long for it to come home again. Can we bring the love back? I know that it's been way too long. You've always been on me, all is wrong.
I met you dancing with a drink in your hand. Drunk and never called me again. But you seen sides and nobody else knows. I need you around to see my kids grow old. Patience, these curses on generations. Let's fall back in love and break. Nothing's past the conversation. There's always space for you. Cause as we get older, it's hard to reach understanding. See life for no plan B. Oh. Yeah, I could be all around the world, but with the family, it don't mean anything.
The Berg, your Music Central, as well as the Central Washington University Athletics live stream. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Ryan Gildersleeve, your play-by-play broadcaster for all of tonight's action, alongside my color commentator, Jackson Roberts. Man, thank you for being here today. It is a great day to be a Wildcat fan and to be here at the Nicholson Arena. Ladies and gentlemen, we've already seen an action-packed game between our Central Washington Lady Cats and the Montana State Billings Yellow Jackets. Folks, that game, of course, was decided in the favor of the Yellow Jackets. But at the end of the day, the Lady Cats, they came into that game riding a lot of momentum. Hopefully, it won't slow them down too much. When we look at this one, we've got the same kind of situation. Into this game, the Wildcats ride a four-game winning streak, a chance to move it to five, while also making themselves 2-1 in conference play on the season so far. Ladies and gentlemen, we are ringing in the new year with our first bit of conference play here in the Nicholson Pavilion of the season. Folks, how are we doing tonight? Jackson, how are you doing tonight? Are you ready for what we're about to see out here?
Oh, I'm ready. Thank you for having me here. I'm happy to be here for my first basketball game of the season. But yeah, I'm ready. It should be a high-intensity game. Both these guys conference play, so it should be a close, intense game.
Absolutely, and I know. You know, when we looked over at what we saw between the Lady Cat basketball team and, of course, their opponents in the Yellow Jackets, there was an interesting situation there. As Montana State, they're a team that is definitely, when you look at the preliminary stages of the season, they're a team that's always going to be ranked highly. They do a great job of scouting, a great job of recruiting, and they've always got a team that can do something come the beginning of the season. Now, when you look over to the men's side, they haven't been as consistent as the years go on, but this Central Washington team is a team who did not lose a lot of talent from last year coming into this one. So far on the year, they sit at a record of 8-3. One of those losses, of course, coming in conference play. Tonight, they have a chance to right that wrong and give themselves a good start to the season before they head into this Saturday's matchup against Seattle Pacific University. Jackson, there is a ton of factors that go into winning a basketball game, but I wanted to know if there was anything you had picked out that really could affect the game and send it to one side or the other.
Well, Angelo Lloyd has been a big hot and cold guy. If he gets hot, he's going to be really hot for this team, and he can get it going for us. Same goes for Bradley Swilly. It seems like he's going to be coming off the bench, though. It looks like Seth Dawson will be taking his place in the starting lineup, but hopefully Swilly can be a good six-man spark plug off the bench for us. One other thing I was looking at was the points margin, the difference in games. The Wildcats, it's 13 points, 12.7, 13 if you round up, and then for the Yellow Jackets, it is 6.2 margin of difference. So the Wildcats have been winning by a much bigger margin, so hopefully that comes into play today.
Exactly. You know, this is a Wildcat team which, especially over the winter break, we just saw jump into another gear. When you give an exhibition matchup to this Wildcat basketball team, they're doing everything they possibly can to not only pull out a win, but to put up as many points as humanly possible against whoever their unlucky opponent may be. Now, let me tell you, when we look into this game here tonight, there are a lot of different factors. As you mentioned, Angelo Lloyd has had quite the season. When he's hot, he is really hot. You also look towards Bradley Swilly, another player that you mentioned. He is fast. His hops can really take him all the way up to the second level concourse where we're broadcasting this here game. He's a guy that can jump from anywhere on the court, and he can get the ball to go. Now, as we look down the roster, there's a couple of other players that are definitely going to play into how this game ends up. Of course, you have to look at Wildcat leading scorer and rebounder, Samad Hector, when you look towards who is the most safe bet to go off in this game. Though, when you look down the list, there are a couple of players who may be in spots that they're not going to be as the season moves forward. More specifically, you look at the standing of Cameron McNeil. So far, a slow start to the season. The North Carolina resident has come back to this team and has played his role perfectly in terms of the defense that he provides on the perimeter, as well as moving the ball around when he is in the game. But when it comes to scoring, last year's leading scorer this year comes in and coming into this game averaging just a hair under 10 points a game. So it's going to be a big decision to see if Cameron McNeil is going to continue playing the way that he plays, where really he's letting everything flow around him. When he gets the ball, he's going to get to the inside, and he's a player that is really one of the most dangerous slashers in the GNAC, if you ask me. Now, when we're looking at guards that are able to put points up on the interior, there is definitely a big exclamation point next to Cameron McNeil's name. So expect him tonight to be seeking out shots not only from the mid-range and the interior, but with the three-point shooter that he is, we could definitely see him get active from beyond the arc. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the buzzer's going to sound. We've got 20 minutes for the first half loaded up on the clock. We're going to take a quick break and be back with you for the beginning of this game in just a moment.
When the bird would like...
Won the Berg, your Music Central, as well as the Central Washington University Athletics live stream. Ladies and gentlemen, we're back here after a quick break. We've got players being introduced here on the court, and we've got all kinds of festivities taking place here in the Nicholson Arena. As folks, this is our first time back in the Nicholson Pavilion, at least for conference play, since last year. So for a lot of folks, this is really what you could consider to be the beginning of the regular season. If you ask me, it's the first time we play any conference competitor. But it does definitely change as you move from person to person. Now, as we look towards the court, as I mentioned before, still introducing the players, as it appears that, you know, this is going to be a game where Central Washington, like we mentioned before, they've got a lot of momentum that they're riding into this matchup. Montana State, not only have they been riding a little bit of momentum themselves, but they just watched their team practically take over every portion of the court against the Lady Cats. So they'd have to be hoping that there's some sort of game plan they can take advantage of, and some sort of exploit that they can find against a Central Washington team that really doesn't let up anywhere. Now, when you look at where it might be a slight bit of an issue for the Central Washington team tonight, you have to look towards the post. The post is a dangerous place for the Wildcats, as a lot of their scoring takes place there. We don't see a whole lot of three-point shooting from the men's team as opposed to the women's team, though this is a team that is comprised of all shooters, all guys that I would definitely trust putting it up from beyond the arc. But, you know, this is a team that they pick their spots very, very carefully, and a lot of the times it works out in their favor. So tonight, we'll see if Central Washington is able to continue along that trope and build some sort of reputation for themselves as they head into their first big-ticket game of the season here against Montana State Billings.
Yeah, I want to get back to the three-point shooting like you were talking about. Montana State Billings is shooting at a, it looks like, 38% clip from three. So Wildcats are definitely going to have to defend the perimeter quite well while our team is shooting at 330%.
Exactly. And now, folks, as we look towards the court, we're just about getting ready for the tip-off as this game gets ready to begin. Folks, it has been a long time coming. Your Central Washington men's basketball team is back here on the court. And here we go. Samad Hector's going to win the tip-off. And just like that, it'll be Seth Dawson bringing it up for the Wildcats. Seth Dawson now driving out left. He's going to send it over to Samad Hector. Samad Hector driving, putting up a shot, but he's blocked. Rebounded now by Montana State Billings, and we are right on into it. This one tossed out to the corner. Back up to the top of the key, and it's passed out again. Now number zero passing to the interior is going to be off. It's going to be taken by Central Washington as they force their first turnover of the game. And then Kevin Holden, a shifty layup he puts up there, showing off the athleticism, but he's unable to get it to connect.
Yeah, it looked like he tried to go for the under-the-basket reverse there. Couldn't quite get it just because he was fouled. It's a little fall, but he seems to be doing good. Making his way to the line.
As Kevin Holden, so far on the season, he's been great from practically everywhere. When you look towards his free throw numbers, about 75% he's shooting so far on the season, as that one's put up and missed. Still no scoring on the game so far, though we are only 26 seconds in. Here is the second shot put up, and this one will be knocked down. So Kevin Holden gets this one to go. And now here comes Montana State Billings once again as they charge against the Wildcats. Passes to the right side corner, and now back up to the top of the key. It's Kevin Holden working against the primary ball handler of the Jackets. Shot is put up, foul is called, and he will not connect. So just like that, there's going to be free throws put up, it so appears, by the Yellow Jackets. And yes, it will be a foul called against Kevin Holden. And like we previously mentioned, that will send Montana State Billings to the line.
When drew the foul and when committed the foul? Just tried to get quick hands, but caught a little bit of arm. So that's going to send him to the line.
And, you know, these fans, they really do get riled up when they have an opportunity to throw off the opposing team. We'll see what we're able to find out here. As folks, I do want to quickly correct a mistake that I made earlier, as it is not Seth Dawson in the game. It's Jordan Clark starting at point guard for the Wildcats. But now Kevin Holden has the ball in hand. Pass to Samad Hector for three in the corner. This one is up and off. Almost rebounded by Sanders, but he can't reel it in. This one will find its way out of bounds, and it'll stay in the possession of Central Washington. As now it'll be Kevin Holden, seemingly the inbounder for the Wildcats. As he tosses this one up, it's going to be up and over the defender and into the hands of Cameron McNeil. McNeil now driving onto the inside, puts this one up, but it's knocked away. Montana State Billings takes over, and here they are on the other end. Here's the toss. He's going to lose the ball, but he will save it straight into the hands of Jordan Clark. Here comes Clark. He's got Samad Hector wide open. Here it goes, and down the jam comes Samad Hector with an incredible play, as here comes Montana State Billings trying to do what they can to answer back, and they will! Maverick Sanders, welcome to Division II. A big drive, and the dunk finishes at the rim. Foul is called.
We got a dunk contest going on right now.
That we do. At least a competition of some sorts between these two teams. One would have to assume that we're going to see some continued, I don't even know what to call it, animosity down here.
Aggression right now.
What a game, as here's Maverick Sanders. We're only a minute and a half in, but it's already something different. Sanders puts up a shot. This one's off. Foul is called, though, so it appears that he will go to the line to shoot a couple. Game is currently tied at 3. 3-3, your current score. A free throw to both sides, as well as a dunk.
Maverick Sanders, so far on the season, free throw shooting has not been shooting from the best clip. 417, so under 500%.
And now, like we previously mentioned, Maverick Sanders putting up the shot. This one's going to fall for him. And so that will push his point total to 4. Or excuse me, push the Wildcat point total to 4, while his pushes itself into the 1 category.
It's a team effort.
That it is. So here's Maverick Sanders, and he's going to miss the second free throw. So it's going to be up and off the back iron. And it's going to be brought in by Montana State Billings. Now here's Montana State bringing it up. Here's a shot. This one is up and off. Rebounded by Samad Hector, who comes flying over the rest of the pack. Now it's Cameron McNeil, ball in hand. Here he drives. He goes up for the layup, and he gets it to go. So, folks, just what we were talking about before the beginning of the game, Cameron McNeil is electric when he gets into the post. So we'll see what's happening here as a shot is put up on the perimeter by Montana State. Rebounded, though, by Maverick Sanders. And here he drives. He's got two men on the interior, and there's going to be a foul called this time. It appears against Central Washington. It will be against Maverick Sanders.
It looked like he tried to attempt a little bit of a Euro step and eventually lost the ball and ran into the defender, which I believe they're calling a charge foul. What looked like, maybe?
Something along those lines. As
it's Montana State Billings ball.
That it is. The inbounder for Montana State will be Jalen Tott. On the season, this has been quite the team over in Billings, Montana. As here is Tott bringing the ball up. Excuse me, it's going to be passed out one more time. They're looking towards the post. Instead, they pass it out to the exterior. It'll fall into the hands of number 5, Steven Richardson, but he steps out before he's able to put up a shot, and possession goes back to the Wildcats.
A little too much contact there.
And so it will once again be Jordan Clark, the inbounder, as here's this one tossed up to Kevin Holden. Kevin Holden now coming across half court. And now the Wildcats moving the ball around a little bit. It falls back into the hands of Cameron McNeil, who scrolls out right, puts up a mid-range shot, but that one's off. And the ball will find its way out of bounds off the hand of Samad Hector.
That would have been a pretty nice step-back jumper, but the defender was just all over that and got a hand on it.
As now we continue to let this game develop. It's Montana State Billings bringing it in once again. Now driving against Jordan Clark. Passed out once again. Now out to the top of the key. On the perimeter, they move the ball around. Montana State looking for an open man. Here's the drive. Shot is put up. No foul is called. And it's going to be off. Rebounded now by Central Washington as Cameron McNeil has the ball in hand. McNeil moving out right. He's going to take a step back three. This one is up and off, though. And the rebound is going to go to Colby Jeanette, who gives it right back to Cameron McNeil. He's going to get that one to go 10 out of 10 times. 8-3, your current score as the Wildcats pull ahead by 5. Now here's Montana State trying to get it across half court. Step back. Shot is put up. This one off the back iron. And the rebound goes to Samad Hector. Samad Hector tosses over to Cameron McNeil, the two leading scorers of this Wildcat team last year. Cameron McNeil gets the lane again. Instead kicks out. Now Kevin Holden. Samad Hector driving. And he's going to lose the ball before he makes it to the rim. So this one's going to be brought back in by Tott. And here comes Montana State. Tossed out left. Now to number 12. He's going to drive. Pass back out Tott. Shot's put up. From beyond the arc, this one is up and off. Rebounded by Samad Hector. That shot was put up by Bryce Whitaker, but no dice. Now a foul is called on the court, and it's going to be Jordan Clark, the inbounder, though a couple of substitutions may change that. And it's going to be Kevin Holden coming out of the game, and this will be the only change for the Wildcats as Seth Dawson takes his place. And I spoke a little bit too soon there, as now Angelo Lloyd is going to come into the game in the place of Jordan Clark. Now Angelo Lloyd in the game, as well as a few different teammates. Got Seth Dawson, Cameron McNeil, Samad Hector, and of course Colby Jeanette out there with him. As it's going to be Seth Dawson bringing the ball up for the Wildcats now. He's got it here at the top of the key, searching for something. A little bit of movement amongst the bigs. He's going to give this one over, and it's going to find its way to Samad Hector. Now Samad Hector tossing out to Cameron McNeil. McNeil working against his defender. He moves out left. Now he's going to toss it to Samad, who pulls on the three. This one off the back iron, though, and rebounded by Montana State. So Montana State jumping back into offensive possession as they pass the ball around the perimeter a couple of times. Now it's going to go back out to Tott. Tott scrolls out, shoots it out right. Drive, shot is put up. This one is off, though. That one was attempted by Benny Fungala. And instead, the Wildcats take possession. So now moving it around, it is Seth Dawson with the ball in hand at the top. He's going to drive, kick back out to Colby Jeanette, who's going to toss over to Angelo Lloyd. Puts up the three. This one is off, though, and it's going to be rebounded by Montana State.
Great ball movement, though.
Absolutely, as they move the ball around the perimeter once again here. Now driving, looking to see if they can get a shot on the interior. They will, and that's going to be knocked down by Fungala.
Defense seemed to back off a little bit there. Didn't want to commit the foul.
Now the Wildcats bringing it up. It's Seth Dawson. He's going to toss up to Colby Jeanette. Jeanette now back to Dawson. Dawson's going to give this one over to Angelo Lloyd. Lloyd now is going to give it back out. Dawson driving against his defender. He's going to put the shot up, but this one is off. Second chance opportunity, and he drains it. So 2 points to the favor of Central Washington. Double their opponent's score, 10-5. Now Montana State. Ball in hand, sitting around that big logo of the Nicholson Arena. Tossing it around once more. And it'll be back out. Moving out left is Montana State. Tosses over to Tott. Tott now driving. Puts up the shot, and it's blocked by Samad Hector. So Samad Hector gets the block and the rebound, and then the call's going to come shortly after. A media timeout is taken, and we're going to take one, too. So, folks, we'll be back in about 30 seconds to a minute, not only here on 88.1 The Berg, but also on the Central Washington University Athletics live stream.
88.1 The Berg would like to thank...
Won the Berg, your Music Central, as well as the Central Washington University Athletics live stream. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the action. 10-5, your current score, as Central Washington University has doubled up their opponents, the Montana State Billings Yellow Jackets, in the beginning stages of this game. About 6 minutes, give or take, have elapsed in this first half of action. Of course, for those of you who are carrying over from the women's game, for college basketball, things do split quite differently amongst the genders, as it is the women's team that will play with quarters, as the men's team plays on a half system. Now it's Angelo Lloyd. He will be the inbounder for the Wildcats as he tosses into Bradley Swilly. Back to Lloyd, and it'll be Seth Dawson bringing it up. Dawson now. He'll bring this one up and work against Whitaker. He moves out left, gets the screen from Swilly, hands it off to Swilly now. And here's Swilly moving around the exterior, trying to get shifty with his defender. He tosses this one out to Mitch Brizzi. Brizzi now toss around a couple of times, and here's Angelo Lloyd, mid-range shot. This one is up and off, rebounded once again by Brizzi, so two straight on this trip to that side of the court. And now with Angelo Lloyd, he's going to toss out to Colby Jeanette, who will miss the three-pointer. It'll find its way to the ground before it gets into the hands of any specific player, and they're going to call this in the possession, it appears, of the Montana State Billings Yellow Jackets.
I'll tell you what, though, Mitch Brizzi is getting a lot of boards, especially offensive rebounds, creating second and third opportunities for us. So that is big time.
That it is. It really does help when you look at the time of possession amongst the teams. If that was a stat that was recorded, Central Washington would surely be in the driver's seat, as now it's tossed around a couple of times, and Montana State Billings looks to force their way to the interior, but not unable to get past Mitch Brizzi, and a foul is going to be called against Brizzy, but not to take away anything from how aggressive his defense was while still maintaining it for the first part of that little session, as you may call it. And it is the Yellow Jackets waiting to inbound the ball. Referee blows the whistle, and now we're started up once again. Inbound comes in, and here's Montana State, but a foul is going to be called against Mitch Brizzy once again, or so it appears. Or no, so it's Angelo Lloyd who's going to be accredited with the first foul. And just a quick correction, it was Colby Jeanette who picked up the prior foul, not Mitch Brizzy. Yeah,
Jeanette got a little bit of arm, and then Angelo just got a little bit of, just trying to get around the screen.
As now it's Montana State trying to do something here, working against the Wildcat defense. Here's Bradley Swilly, or excuse me, not Bradley Swilly, but Mitch Brizzy, matched up against the primary guard of this Montana State team. He's not going to force any sort of, or he's not going to allow any sort of points from Montana there as the ball finds its way out of bounds. But possession will stay in the side of Montana State. And now moving the ball around. Here's the drive, shot's put up, and it won't fall. A clean play there by Mitch Brizzy, and here comes Seth Dawson with the ball in hand. Dawson now shoots to Brizzy outright. Brizzy's going to hand it back off and set the screen. Dawson's going to drive, puts up the shot, but this one is up and off. Just a bad spin on the ball off the basket. And now here they come. Montana State driving. Originally getting Bradley Swilly to jump there, but the ball is passed out. Now working against Seth Dawson are the Yellow Jackets. Shots put up, and it will fall. So just like that, it's another 2 points on the board for Montana State. They cut the lead down to 3 for the Wildcats, and here comes Angelo Lloyd, passing now over to Seth Dawson. Dawson working here at the top of the key. He's got a little bit of movement. Swilly out right. He's going to take the screen from Swilly and then now, or excuse me, from Brizzy. This one's moved around a couple of times, and the pass intended for Mitch Brizzy will find its way out of bounds before touching his hands.
Wildcats need to keep going back to that, though. Brizzy is a big body. He can set those screens, and they can get either mid-range just jumpers, or if they have it open lane to the hoop, they can get an easy layup.
We'll see if they're able to implement him as that anchor that you're kind of mentioning there. We'll see what they're able to do, but you know, that post is such a difficult spot for the Wildcats. If anyone gets in there, you know, a lot of the times we've got some guys who can send it back, but it's difficult to see. As here's Montana State bringing the ball around the exterior. And that right there, ladies and gentlemen, is 2 points. Or no, is the travel called?
That should have been called a travel. I don't think they did, but...
Well, ladies and gentlemen, if those 2 points do count, which it appears that they do not, those would have been registered to number 0. Get this, ladies and gentlemen. Famous Left Hand. That's right. This man named Famous Left Hand will come in to play against Central Washington, joining the Hall of Fame class of opposing player names, which already includes the likes of Biggie Bergerson and all kinds of different players which have graced the Nicholson Arena with their presence over the years. Folks, what a time to be a Central Washington fan, as I don't know how I would feel if I missed the real, I wouldn't say homecoming, but definitely the arrival of Famous Left Hand here in Ellensburg.
I hope he's right-handed, too.
That'd be pretty... You know, that definitely would be funny. You gotta, you know, he's right-handed because the left hand is the one that's famous. He's gotta keep that for doing all of the fun things. Maybe he's a hand model. Who knows?
There's
a lot of money in that nowadays, I hear. Just put on a couple of rings, look all nice. Hey, who knows? As long as it's not a GNAC ring at the end of this season, yep, that doesn't matter to me. So, folks, as we look towards the court, we've still got a break going on as both of these teams trying to formulate a game plan to jump ahead. Central Washington, of course, has had the reins in their hands since really the beginning of this matchup, still yet to trail, but there's always something that can change on the flip of a dime. And, folks, if there's anything we know about this Central Washington basketball team, it is that if something's going to happen, they're going to make it happen, and they're going to force it to happen, really.
Yeah, we're sitting here with 11:49 left in the first half, so we'll see. It's 10-7. We'll see if the scoring can pick up a little bit, as it seems like there's been the refs have not been afraid to blow the whistle a little bit, call the fouls, so it has slowed down the game just a little bit.
As Montana State Billings inbounds the ball now, this one's tossed up, and it's going to be in the hands of Tott. Tott now moving it around a couple of times, tosses this one into the interior, and it's going to be a Famous Left Hand going up with the right hand and getting the score. And here come the Wildcats. Angelo Lloyd, ball in hand, moving out right against the Yellow Jackets. He tosses to Colby Jeanette. Colby Jeanette now out to Bradley Swilly, who nails the mid-range shot. And just like that, two more on the board for the Cats.
Beautiful look.
Absolutely. A three-point lead now they hold. Here's left hand. He's going to toss up. This one is going to go from tot over a couple of times. And now it'll return itself into the hands of famous left hand. Left hand's going to put up the mid-range shot. This one is off, and it's rebounded now by Angelo Lloyd. Angelo Lloyd bringing it up, takes the three-pointer. This one's up and off, so unable to score on the fast break three-point opportunity. Ball will find its way out of bounds, and Central Washington will lose possession.
I can confirm famous left hand is right-handed. He just shot that shot right-handed, so.
Which is quite the, it's quite ironic, frankly.
Contradicting a little bit.
That it is. But it's a name that will land you in the history books one way or another. And I imagine that it's worked so far, as here is Montana State once again. It's Tott, ball in hand. He will lose it, but the whistles will blow, and we'll see how they call it.
Looks like they called it kickball.
As five fouls committed by the Wildcats in this first half of action so far. We're about 40 seconds away from what would have been the end of the first quarter, as now this one's tossed back out to Tott. Tott working against Swilly. He tosses out. This one to left hand over to his left. Now driving, putting up the shot and missing are the Yellow Jackets as Samad Hector reels in another board. He's going to give this one to Swilly. Swilly now working his way up court, giving an open look, and you cannot do that typically. But this one won't land, and it's going to be Montana State bringing the ball back into their possession. Here's Tott working against the Wildcats in the transition. Puts up the shot, but it's off. Rebounded by Angelo Lloyd, and we're back in business. Seth Dawson receives the pass, and here he comes. He's going to put up a three of his own, and that one off the back iron. Rebounded by Samad Hector. Second chance points will go, and just like that, you see how versatile Samad Hector can be. Not only filling the lane correctly, but bringing in the rebound on the offensive side and getting points to go along with it. Here's Tott bringing it up for Montana State as he tosses out right, and they move it around the perimeter once more. Left hand now driving. He's working against Wildcat defender, but not going to be able to keep him from the basket there. So 2 points to his favor. And here comes Seth Dawson. He tosses out left to Samad Hector. Hector now driving, looking to get some more opportunities in the paint. He looks to force one here. Instead, he tosses out. Dawson to Swilly for three. This one is up and off, rebounded by Montana State. And once again, we will see these teams work with a three-point separation. This shot's put up, and it will go. So that's going to be number five, Steven Richardson of the Yellow Jackets, getting the shot to go and recording his 6th points of the game so far.
The Wildcats are getting way too comfortable shooting these threes right now. They obviously, most of our points has come from in the paint. I don't think we've scored 1 3-pointer tonight, so we're waiting for that first one to drop, but I've just noticed that was about 4 or 5 3-pointers that not one of them dropped, and that was a span of a couple minutes.
Right, and you know, this is a team that, like we mentioned before, they do shoot the ball sometimes, but when they do, they typically choose very carefully when they're going to execute with that play. So it's interesting to see how they're going to move forward and how they're going to implement this game plan coming out of the timeout.
The looks haven't been that bad, honestly. It's just they haven't been able to get any of them to drop so far. So might have to just keep shooting them, but you don't want to risk letting Montana State Billings catch up to us.
Exactly. Trying not to get into a negative rhythm from beyond the arc either, as the Wildcats put the ball in play, and just like that, we're back. Kevin Holden in the game once again.
You got a full court press too.
As the Wildcats make a substitution. Now here's Cameron McNeil driving and losing the basketball. It's going to be taken over by Montana State. Now it's tossed out once more, and it's Richardson. Richardson hands it off to Tott. Tott now coming around, working against Jordan Clark here. He tosses out left. And now Montana State looking to get some sort of opportunity. They've got 11 seconds to make it happen. Driving out left is Tott. He tosses back to the top with Richardson. Richardson returns the favor. Now tossed cross court. Shot needs to be put up in 4 seconds. It's tossed back out for Tott. Gets it before the shot clock, but won't be able to connect. Second chance opportunity. Won't be able to connect. And now a third opportunity for this team, as a wide open 3-point shot from the corner won't fall. And Samad Hector brings in yet another rebound. Now here is Cameron McNeil. He's got the ball in hand for the Wildcats, moving out left. A pass intended for Samad Hector is quickly given up by two Richardson, and he's going to get an easy layup on the other end to give Montana State the lead, their first of the game. They now lead by 1, 14-15 your score. Kevin Holden with the ball in hand. moving out left now towards the top of the key, sitting in the middle of that logo. A little bit of movement. Here comes Samad Hector. He's going to take the screen, toss it back to Samad. Samad gives it over to Cameron McNeil, who drives, gets a mid-range shot, and won't be able to hit. Samad Hector, though, gets the second-chance opportunity, sends it back to McNeil, who gives it to Holden. Holden with a step back, driving now against his defender, looking for something. He's being double-teamed for a moment there, but the jump ball is going to put a tack in it.
Second chance opportunities. Like I said earlier, we've been getting a lot of them. Earlier it was from Brizzy, but now Hector seems to be getting in there and getting in the paint and getting a lot of boards.
And you know, those are the two guys to look for on that interior. So folks, as they take a timeout on the court, we'll take one too and be back in just a moment after we identify our station quickly and we return to not only 88.1 The Berg, but the Central Washington University Athletics live stream.
All the songs.
On the Berg, your Music Central, as well as the Central Washington University Athletics live stream. Folks, welcome back to the action. 14-15 your score as Central Washington trails it by a single point here in the Nicholson Arena. We'll now look to see what these teams can do coming out of the timeout, what plays are drawn up, and who they're going to target here, as so far on the night it's been quite the even matchup. Now it'll be the Wildcats, more specifically Bradley Swilly inbounding. He gives it to Kevin Holden, who takes the three and won't be able to hit. And just like that, second chance opportunity is put up and knocked down by Maverick Sanders. So 2 points to his total. That gives him three on the night so far. Now Tott with the ball in hand, working against Holden. He's going to drive out left. Screen's not going to connect, but he's going to give him the pass anyway. Shot's put up, and this one's going to go. So Samad Hector unable to shut down that mid-range opportunity as the Yellow Jackets put a couple more on the board to keep the separation at one. Maverick Sanders, ball in hand. He gives this one over to Bradley Swilly, who moves out left. Gives this one over to Samad Hector, who now drives for an in-the-paint opportunity. He's going to lose his defender, and he's going to get it down. So just like that, the Wildcats forcing another 2 points in and taking the lead once again. If you're looking for lead changes, this potentially could be the game for that, as we've seen three in the last three drives. Here's Tott with the ball in hand. He hands it over a couple of times, and this one intended for famous left hand. Instead, it finds its way out of bounds. And it appears that the Wildcats have taken possession of the basketball. So Bradley Swilly will be the inbounder. And it'll be Kevin Holden receiving. So now Holden coming in. He'll have Samad Hector out left. Maverick Sanders in front of him. He's going to go out right and hand this one off to Jordan Clark. Clark now over to Swilly, and here comes Swilly. He gives it over to Holden. Holden still maneuvering on the outside. Pass intended for Samad Hector. Doesn't make it there properly. And after the whistles blow, it's going to be an interesting call.
It's like Zeron Richmond. Oh, I thought he was maybe grabbing on one of our players. Thought that was going to be a defensive foul, but looks like they called offense.
Yeah, so the foul is not going to go in Central Washington's favor. Still, we have not seen either team enter the bonus, though Central Washington does have six fouls against themselves. Here is Montana State moving the ball around the perimeter. This one tossed into left hand on the inside, and he's going to be blocked by Jordan Clark. So Jordan Clark gets up and rejects that one. And Montana State will end up empty-handed on the first go at this drive.
It was a beautiful cut by left hand, but Clark just recovered so fast and was able to get the block.
And that's what matters, you know. If you're thinking from a video game perspective, he's got pogo stick unlocked, that's for sure. That guy can jump as much as he so needs to. As here's Montana State moving the ball around, they're going to toss it up and elect for Tott. Tott will work against Holden, driving out left now, uses the screen. Now this one's tossed over, and a three-point shot is attempted from deep. This one is off, though, and rebounded by left hand. Left hand driving, he's going to put up a shot with the right hand, and he's going to get it to go. So two more points on the board. That's going to once again cause a lead change,
lead change.
And just like that, Central Washington retaining possession of the basketball, now trailing by 1 point. Kevin Holden with the ball in hand. He crosses that half-court logo, takes the screen from Samad Hector, and tosses out left to Sanders. Sanders now gives it to Clark, and Clark will find Samad Hector. Hector now trying to find, once again, an in-the-paint opportunity. This time he's unable to score on it, and Montana State drives on the fast break. They give it out for Ty, who shoots the three. This one won't fall. So not a lot of three-pointers going in the favor of either one of these teams so far in this game, but here's a great pass to Maverick Sanders. Credit the assist to Bradley Swilly, and just like that, the Wildcats continue to tack it on. They now once again lead by 1 point as the fifth lead change of, I believe, the last five drives. Now here's left hand. He's trying to toss it over out left, and it's going to move that way once more. Here's Todd with the ball in hand, working against Kevin Holden. He's on the outside now. He's got Samad Hector in his face as well. A couple of nice passes, and a three-pointer is going to fall from the outside. That's going to be number 22, Kai Kuba of Montana State, knocking down the three-pointer as here's Maverick Sanders with the ball in hand for the Cats. He tosses out to Samad Hector, who takes a three and won't be able to answer back as it's rebounded by the very same Kai Kuba. Kuba now will bring it up and instead elect to give it to Todd. Todd will attack Kevin Holden once more. As now working out right, he makes the pass to left hand and it's returned. Now this one over to Kuba. Kuba back out to Richardson. Richardson driving now against Maverick Sanders. Wants a shot, gets it, doesn't convert. Now it's going to find its way back to the Wildcat favor. And that was a tough hit if you saw that one. As here comes the Wildcats. Samad Hector has an open look. A power play for the Wildcats and they won't be able to get it to go. But Samad Hector does draw the foul on that shot. So now with 4 minutes and 24 seconds remaining in this first half of action, Samad Hector is going to get a chance to tie this game up.
90% free throw shooter too, so the odds are looking pretty good that we can tie this up right here.
Absolutely. You know, Samad Hector is one of those guys, he's kind of like a Swiss Army knife. Wherever you've got him, if he's on the basketball court, he's going to be producing.
And you told me beforehand, his post game is really great. I love how he can use the elbow a little bit to wrap around the defender without pushing too much and getting called for a foul. He's able to just get around the defender that way, and it works quite well.
As the first free throw will be up and off the back iron, we're going to see practically a platoon swap for the Wildcats here is coming into the game. Or, I guess, more easily put, in the game for the Wildcats now will be Samad Hector, Cameron McNeil, Angelo Lloyd, Seth Dawson, and it will be Mitch Brizzy in just a second. I believe that I already stated his name, but Colby Jeanette still in the game for the Cats. And it appears that's not going to change. Instead, it's going to be Mitch Brizzy coming into the game for Samad Hector.
And both free throws were missed, but we were able to obtain possession. It went off one of the Yellow Jackets' hands, so we will maintain possession under our basket.
As it'll be Seth Dawson inbounding for the Wildcats as they look to still register some points. This one tossed up and over, and Jalo Lloyd will grab it. Now making his way up past half court, he gives it over to Seth Dawson. Dawson driving, a foul is called, and it will be against Montana State, or so it appears. And it will be, that one's going to be called against Benny Fangula. And 22-20, still our score. Central Washington will search for another couple of points here on this end, as Colby Jeanette thought he'd be the inbounder. Instead, it's going to be Angelo Lloyd. Angelo now tossing in, and it's going to be Jeanette handing it right back to him. Lloyd now handing over to Dawson. Dawson moving out left, scrolling back towards the top of the key. He's going to pass in, and it's going to find its way out to Cameron McNeil. McNeil now driving. He's going to toss it to Brizzy, who gets it to go. So an assist to McNeil, and 2 more points on the board for Mitch Brizzy, his first 2 of the game. Now here are the Yellow Jackets moving it around. In the game at point guard is the other top brother, Jahan, as he makes the pass out right. And the Yellow Jackets look to be running supposedly the same offense, especially by movement's sake, with the different top brother in the game. This one tossed, and they're going to look for an in. And they're going to look for that paint opportunity. They got it quickly, and they converted on it just as soon. So now a 2-point lead for Montana State as Seth Dawson brings it up. Dawson now has Colby Jeanette moving out right. He's not going to take a screen. Instead, Seth Dawson is going to still have the ball where he puts up a three, but that one's up and off, and it'll be out of bounds on the favor of Central Washington. So Central Washington retains the basketball.
Well, we just saw Montana State Billings check in Emmanuel Ajinaku. He is a big fella. He can rival a Brizzy right now for some offensive rebounds. He's just a big guy.
Absolutely. And, you know, size is just such a big factor when you're playing a game like this. So, folks, as they take a timeout on the court, we're going to take one, too, and be back in just a few moments for the final 3 minutes of the first half of action. The Berg, your Music Central, alongside the Central Washington University Athletics live stream. Welcome back to the action, folks. I'm Ryan Gildersleeve, your play-by-play broadcaster, alongside Jackson Roberts on color for tonight. Here's Angelo Lloyd with the ball in hand off the inbound, and he's going to give it over to Seth Dawson, who gets it started for the Wildcats. Moving out left now, he's at the top of the key. He's going to pass this one over to Cameron McNeil. McNeil now driving against his defender, steps back, puts up the mid-range shot, and won't be able to get it to go. Instead, it's going to be rebounded now by Montana State, and they'll bring it down in the hands of Tott. He's got a few options here, but not a lot of movement. Working against Seth Dawson. He's going to pass this one over to the big. Working from about the free throw line, he tosses over once more. Now back to the interior, and Mitch Brizzy is looking to put an end to what scoring he may have. A shot is put up, but whistles blow, and it's going to be fouls against Montana State. That'll be their sixth of the period so far, and with 2.5 minutes remaining in the half, we've got a 2-point separation between these two teams in what has been an extremely low-scoring bout. Here is Seth Dawson bringing it up for the Cats. The Wildcats moving around here. Here's Colby Jeanette out left. He's got Mitch Brizzy, his closest big. He's going to give this one out now to Cameron McNeil. McNeil now will work against his defender, head out right, driving. He's looking for somebody. We'll move around a little bit and find Angelo Lloyd. Angelo Lloyd now driving. He's going to put this one up, and you can't let him do that. Angelo Lloyd has been a great slasher, showing the exact same sort of skill set that we see in Cameron McNeil, as here are the Yellow Jackets looking to mount some sort of an answer to what we saw on that last drive. 24-24, game is tied. Here's Colby Jeanette playing defense against the Yellow Jackets here, but they're instead going to elect to send it back to the perimeter. Now it's being moved around just a slight bit. Shot not going to be taken, but the pump fake definitely got me. This one will find its way out of bounds.
Cam McNeil has been playing amazing defense of that possession right there. He was able to force the ball out of bounds there too, keep it in our possession, it looks like, but he was also just playing great perimeter defense, staying with his guy through the screen. Eventually got switched, but still, like I said, made the play in the paint.
And you know, let me tell you, man, Cameron McNeil, like we mentioned before this game even started, he is just amazing when it comes to slashing. And when you're talking about that attribute for a guard, he's definitely at the top of that list. As here's Seth Dawson with the ball in hand, he tosses out right to Angelo Lloyd, takes a step back, puts up the mid-range shot. This one is up and off. Rebounded now by Tott, and here come the Yellow Jackets in transition. Tott's going to drive. Looks like he wants the shot himself. He's instead going to toss out to the exterior. This one to Fungala. Fungala puts up the shot, and this one is up and off. Second chance up, this one will be up and good. Now it's going to be Angelo Lloyd, ball in hand. He drives, gives it back over to Brizzy. Brizzy back to Lloyd, and here he comes. Moving out right, he puts up the mid-range and gets this one to go. So a dagger on the move from Angelo Lloyd is going to give the Wildcats a little bit of a breather as they've tied this game once more. Less than a minute remaining in the game. 26 seconds on the shot clock. And here are the Yellow Jackets trying to put something on the board before the end of this first half of action. A mid-range shot is put up, but this one is going to find the hands of Angelo Lloyd before it finds a basket. Tossed out right to Seth Dawson. Dawson now driving, and there's going to be a foul called. This one will be against Central Washington University, putting Montana State Billings in the bonus, as that is our seventh foul of the quarter.
I don't know if that was a charge. I don't know if his feet were set. Might have been blocking, but ref's going to call the charge.
Yeah, they're going to call something, whatever it may be. And so with that being said, they take a timeout on the court. We'll take one, too, and be back in just a moment for the final 40 seconds of this first half of action. One the Berg, your Music Central, as well as the Central Washington University Athletics live stream. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Ryan Gildersleeve, your play-by-play broadcaster for all of tonight's action, alongside my color commentator, Jackson Roberts. Now it's Todd, ball in hand, the primary ball handler, of course, for the Montana State Billings Yellow Jackets. They tossed around a couple of times, as now we've got both of the Todd brothers on the court. And the ball has moved around a bit. Here's the shot put up by Fungala, and he's going to get it to go. So a three-pointer is going to put them in a good spot, now leading by three. 10 seconds for the Wildcats to work with as they try to either match it or at least get something on the board. 5 seconds in Cameron McNeil drive and put up the mid-range shot. He'll get that to go, and that's going to do it for the first half of action. Ladies and gentlemen, your Wildcats only trail it by one as we head into half. For us, we'll be back in just about 5 or so minutes as we return to give you a bit of an update on what happened throughout the first half of our game so far, and maybe a little bit of an update on what we saw earlier today with the women's game. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back in just a moment. 81. 88.1 The Berg, your Music Central, as well as the Central Washington University Athletics live stream. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. If you look towards your screens, if you are on the live stream, you will see a little game that we've got going on amongst the kids here at halftime. But what we're here to do is wrap up this first half of action and really just let you know what you're looking at as we move into the second half of action. Folks, it has been an interesting night so far from a whole different... there's probably about 10 different things I could list that are unique about this game in comparison to others that we've seen throughout this season. Now, of course, the biggest difference between what we've seen throughout the season and today is conference competition today. We haven't seen that much, if at all, at home this season, and I can confirm we have not seen it at home this season. So, an interesting idea here as we look towards this game where the Wildcats only trail it by 1 point, but the discrepancies are easy to see. If you look towards the numbers, the statistics will tell you that Central Washington did not make a three-pointer in the first half of action, though the attempts have always been there. So it's an interesting situation as we see if Central Washington is able to pull their boots together and really get a couple of shots to land. This is a team that is more than competent from beyond the line, and if they're able to change the tides a little bit and show that a little bit more, then they're going to be in good spots and in good tidings. For those radio viewers, you may not have just seen what happened on the court, but a gnarly block. I'm not even sure if we've seen something that vicious in this game. But
he packed him for sure.
Absolutely.
But back on the three-point shooting, they have not had bad looks at all. It's just seemed like they just haven't been able to knock it down. They've been short. They've been too much on it. It's just haven't been able to get that green light, if we're going back to video game terms. But, no, yeah, the three-point shooting has not been great. The scoring in general has not been great for the Wildcats. We're averaging 80 points a game, and we're only at 28 and a half, so that'd be on pace for 56 at the end of the game. But just not on par for our usual offense right now.
Definitely not. I mean, that's a great point to make. This is a Wildcat team that throughout the season so far has just been explosive on offense, really having no shortage of offensive players to command the game. But tonight, like you mentioned, there's definitely been a bit of a lack when it comes to the players that are really just making a name for themselves in just the game that we're watching. Now, of course, things do change as time moves forward, and from minute to minute, we could be watching a completely different basketball matchup. So, as we come into the second half, one would have to imagine that the coaching staff is getting their squad ready for what should be a very physical and I don't want to say very vicious, because I've already used that term, but that's kind of what I'm expecting out of the second half, as both teams look to try and break away and give themselves some sort of reasonable lead to work off of. I mean, it's a difficult sport already to gain confidence in, as things can change, like I've mentioned multiple times throughout this broadcast, on the flip of a dime. But a bright spot for the Wildcats is they've been just playing great on defense. I think that you can make the argument for both sides of this matchup here tonight, as of course the scoreboard in and of itself should tell you that. But really, I don't think that it can be stated enough. This has been a defensive matchup, and both of these teams are showing impressive numbers on really, I imagine, both ends, though the defense, like we've said, has definitely taken taken the driver's seat, per se.
Both teams have shown very quick hands and just quick feet as well, being able to slide in front of their the person they are guarding. But they've also been forcing lots of turnovers, and so that's a key to the game to me, is just keeping the turnovers on the low. We've seen Montana State Billings throw a couple double teams at some of our guys, and it seems like that's where some of our guys get a little bit flustered. We saw in the women's game they were throwing double teams as well quite a bit, and it seems like our players just get a little bit flustered. It's not easy to have that double team running at you, but we got to try to get it to the open man and not turn the ball over.
Exactly. I mean, we saw how much ball security affected the outcome of that first game, as the women did fall by a score of 9. I believe the final score ended up being 73-82. The final score as Central Washington fell in the game against number 17 ranked Montana State Billings. Of course, the women's side, the rankings definitely do. That definitely did favor in the side of Montana State. Though, as we do come into the second half, as we previously mentioned, it's a completely different game, ladies and gentlemen, and you could practically look at it as they're starting the quarter off 0-1, right? Or excuse me, starting off even just the second half and the remainder of this game. If I'm in that locker room right now, I'm telling those players it's a brand new game. You know, kind of the same old stuff that every coach likes to repeat to their guys, but really, that's what the point that needs to be banged home here is These players have nothing to lose as they jump out here, really only trailing by one. As aggressive as they can be coming out the chutes without, you know, giving up too many fouls, they definitely could shift the tide of this game very quickly. But with that being said, folks, Ryan Gildersleeve here, your play-by-play broadcaster for the night alongside Jackson Roberts. And for 88.1 The Berg and your Central Washington Athletics live stream, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a break and be back in about 5 minutes for the beginning of the second half of action here in the Nicholson Arena.
Thank our proud.
88.1 The Berg, your Music Central, as well as the Central Washington University Athletics live stream. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Ryan Gildersleeve, your play-by-play broadcaster for all of tonight's action, alongside my color commentator, Jackson Roberts. Folks, we have just heard the buzzer, and we are ready for the second half of action to commence here from the Nicholson Arena. Your Wildcats currently trail it only by a single point, and with 20 minutes loaded back on the clock, we've got another half of action for your Wildcats to show why they are such a successful team so far on the season.
As far as leading scorers for the Wildcats so far, it looks like it is Cam McNeil and then Samad Hector.
As now it's tossed around a couple of times by the Yellow Jackets as they look to get it going here. Moving it around a little bit here on the perimeter. And now it's going to be put into the hands of Tot. So Tot's going to pass on to the interior with, wow, a shot's put up and knocked down quickly. That one attempted and knocked down by Richmond. So now here's Central Washington bringing it up, looking to answer back. It's Kevin Holden. He's going to toss over to Jordan Clark. Clark now has Maverick Sanders outright. He's going to hit him with it. Now it's tossed over to Cameron McNeil. McNeil now to Hector. Samad Hector's done a great job tonight of finding opportunities on the inside. Looks like he wants one here, and he's going to get it. So that's two more points, and we're going to continue on the path that we left off on at the end of last quarter, which was score, score, score. 2-2-2. We'll see if the Wildcats are able to break that chain here as they look to get a stop. And shot is put up and knocked down. Foul is going to be called, and it looks like that's just about the opposite of what we wanted, as now a free opportunity is going to be given up, as well as a Wildcat foul.
That was a beautiful spin and beautiful find by Tot.
It was. You know, the Tot brothers tonight really have been game-changing for Montana State, as their combined ball handling has really set them apart in terms of their ball control and being able to move it around. Free throw is up, and it's going to be good, so that's going to be yet another point to the favor of Daniel Moody. Moody can be very easily compared to Samad Hector if you look at the numbers that they each average. Now Wildcats pushing it around. Here's Maverick Sanders driving, puts up the shot, and gets it to go.
Strong finish.
Yeah, 2 points, and just like that, we are tied. Or at least we should be. Never mind. I am just about a play behind in my mind. Now here's the shot, and that one's going to go. So that's a three-pointer put up and knocked down quickly by Daniel Moody. And here come the Wildcats. They need to answer back in some form here. Here's Clark giving it over to Hector. Now Jordan Clark using Samad Hector once more. Puts up the mid-range shot and gets that to go. So as they bury that one, that cuts the lead back down to three. Still not where you want to be if you are Central Washington. Now here's Moody driving into the painted area. He puts up a shot and it is off, but a foul is going to be called, so he will once again find his way to the line. One would have to think that he was tapped on the shoulder at half and told that he's going to get a lot of touches here in the second half, as he has gotten practically every pass that's been thrown in the entirety of the second half, which makes up about 2 minutes.
It's actually Richardson at the line. He's shooting 23% from free throw line.
Really?
Yeah.
My apologies. I mixed up Moody and Richardson for a second there, but that's a great grab.
It's okay. I mixed up a 3 and a 9. He's shooting 29%.
Hey, just like that. He does knock down the first one.
Shooting what percent? 29% from free throw line.
Really? So the charity stripe has not been his spot. We'll see if he's able to fall to the hypnotization, and he doesn't. The CW band doing their best to distract free throw shooters when they make it to their end of the court. You love to see it. As here's Jordan Clark bringing the ball up for the Wildcats. He's got Kevin Holden out left. Cameron McNeil out right. He's instead going to choose Colby Jeanette. Now it's to Holden. Holden for three. And this one is off. Rebounded by Montana State, and they look to put a couple more on the board here as they're given an opportunity unanswered. Now it's going to be stolen quickly. This one brought in by Jordan Clark. Clark's got a couple of things to go here as the fast break follows out, and it's going to instead just be the Wildcats putting up a three-point shot, and Jordan Clark buries that one from long range, cuts the lead down to two, and here comes Montana once again to try and answer. Tot with the ball in hand. This is Jalen Tot. As he works against Kevin Holden. Out left, he's got famous left hand. He's going to give it to him. Left hand now is going to give it out to Richardson. Richardson takes the three, and he is just unstoppable in the second half. Extends the lead to five as he hits a long-range shot.
That was fading, too. That was not an easy bucket.
That is not what you want to see if you're Central Washington, as now Jordan Clark looks to recuperate some of those points as he drives forward. Samad Hector coming in with him, but instead he's going to put up the shot himself. Now the rebound is going to go their way, and Samad Hector puts a couple of points up and gets them to go.
Great rebound by Kevin
Holden.
Here comes
Montana State as Tott has the ball in hand. He drives against Kevin Holden. Working his way out left, he's going to make the toss back over to Moody. Moody hands it off to left-hand. Left-hand now working against a number of Central Washington defenders as here comes Richardson. Richardson's going to lose it. It's a steal for Colby Jeanette, who tosses it up to Kevin Holden. This should be fun. Gets it to go. Two more points for the Wildcats. They cut the lead to one. We're back where we've been comfortably for the most of this game. As now it is Tott, who looks to regain some of the momentum that has been lost in these last couple of drives. Moving out left now against Holden. He's going to pass in to Richardson. Richardson back to Tott for three. Bangs it home. So Tott's going to be successful from three, and that's going to push the lead back out to four. Here's Kevin Holden for the Cats. Out left, he's got Samad. Now Samad at the top of the key is going to drive against Richardson. Puts up the shot, won't be able to get it to go. A rebound on the ground to Richardson. Not what you typically see, but it worked for him there. And now Montana moving it up. Here's Famous left hand. He's going to shoot it out left, and it's going to find its way over and now driving against Samad Hector. Shots put up. This one is up and off, though. No second chance opportunity as the ball is taken away by Colby Jeanette, who has been great defensively these last number of minutes. Samad Hector, wide open three. Won't be able to get it to go. The defender did close out right at that last second, so not quite as wide open as it originally was. Tott with the ball in hand. He works his way up, and he's going to shoot this one out to Moody. Moody down to the interior, and now to Richardson. Richardson passes back out. And working against Cameron McNeil is number five as he drives now. Richardson puts it up. My apologies, folks, as that is Steven Richardson. And it is Richmond who wears number 12, Zeron Richmond. So my apologies for the mix-up there. And now, as we are just about 5 minutes into the second half of action, they're going to take a timeout on the court, and we'll take one, too. Be back in just about 30 seconds to a minute here on 88.1 The Berg and the Central Washington University Athletics live stream.
On the Berg would like to thank our proud sponsor.
One, your music central as well as the Central Washington University Athletics live stream. The Berg also goes in with 88.1 your music central, but folks, there is not time to think about names as this game has just been wall to the wall action. We have not really gotten a chance to catch our breaths other than these timeouts since the beginning of this matchup. Folks, it has been a game for, I don't want to say the ages, but it's been a game for quite a while here as the Wildcats are playing their form of basketball against Montana State, that's for sure. They currently trail it by four, and it is Montana State who holds a bit of momentum over their head as they will inbound the basketball coming out of the timeout.
I think that's exactly what the Wildcats needed, playing their brand of basketball, not trying to force up too many threes. Obviously, we saw a couple fly up, and we finally hit our first three-pointers. So just playing our brand of basketball, that's going to be key.
Absolutely, as now we rejoin the action, and it's being moved around just a little bit by Montana State. Now the screen is used, moving in left, now attacking Brizzy on the interior, and the whistles will blow. It's going to go against Montana State, the travel, and it will be Central Washington basketball with just under 15 minutes remaining in this final half of action. Now it's going to be Jordan Clark receives the inbound, and he'll command the offense against Tott. Crossing half court, he drives in from the right side, hands it off to Colby Jeanette, who's a dangerous shooter, definitely underrated for his position. Now the ball finds its way to Bradley Swilly, puts up a athletic layup, but this one's not going to go anywhere other than into the hands of Montana State as they pass it around. Now once again, it's Tott, he's going to toss this one out. And it'll be right back to him. He's working against Colby Jeanette. Puts up a mid-range shot. Gets it to go. Colby Jeanette just a little bit too cold-footed there. Looked like he was on ice as he was shaking a tad before the mid-range shot did fall. Six points separate these two teams as Central Washington looks to recuperate some of that here. Colby Jeanette, we were just talking about his three-point shooting. He's not going to be able to back it up there. And Montana State now drives. On the exterior, they work against Angelo Lloyd and the Wildcat defense. Colby Jeanette once again guarding the ball handler, and he's going to pull in what I believe to be his third recorded steal of the game. As now here's Bradley Swilly driving. He's going to toss out to Jeanette. Jeanette's going to move his way around into Swilly, excuse me, to Brizzy, and that is a perfect assist to a perfect score. Now bringing it up is Tot. Nothing really changes there, as both the Tot brothers have commanded the point guard position since the beginning of this game. Tot with the ball in hand. He moves out right. He's guarded by Colby Jeanette. This one tossed up out a couple of times before it finds its way in the paint. Mitch Brizzy unable to play the defense that he would have wanted, and that ball is going to find its way into the hoop. 6 points still separate these two teams. Jordan Clark going to use the screen for Brizzy, put up a mid-range, and that'll go. So another 2 points.
I like Jordan Clark in the pick and roll for sure.
I do too.
Whether it's Brizzy or Hector, whatever, he seems to be able to pull up those middies.
His playmaking is great. He definitely knows when to take his opportunities. As Tot puts up a mid-range of his own, won't be able to answer properly though, but the rebound does go to Montana before a travel is going to be called. And just like that, Central Washington is given an opportunity to recuperate some of these lost points. A couple of substitutions on the court for both teams, or so it appears, as it's going to be Angelo Lloyd coming out of the game. Kind of interesting, as coming in his place will be Colby Jeanette, who I thought was already on the court. As now here's Jordan Clark, passes out left to Brizzy. Brizzy now to Angelo Lloyd, takes the step back, and now driving is Lloyd. Lloyd loses it, and it's going to be straight into the hands of Richmond. Richmond driving, passes over, and he's got the ball once again. Now against Brizzy, attempts something dangerous, but he's not going to be able to get anywhere close to it, and a foul is going to be called. I will say, if you're asking me, if I was put on some rules committee for the NCAA, I would definitely state that if you're going for a tomahawk dunk over a guy, you're going to expect contact.
Yeah, I don't think any of the fans here like that call at all.
No, I can't imagine so. As here's Richmond attempting yet another set of free throws from the line. He'll miss the first one. Central Washington has committed 4 fouls on the half already to 0 by Montana State. Seth Dawson comes in the game for Jordan Clark. And now a chance to push the lead to 5 for Montana State.
Stadium's getting loud.
Here's Richmond. Guts it. So just like that, it's a 5-point separation between these two squads. 45-50 your score. About 2.5 minutes remaining in what would be the third quarter of action. Tossed over to Brizzy. Brizzy now out to Angelo Lloyd. Now he's going to toss over to Seth Dawson. Dawson now driving, passes out to Swilly. Takes the three, to Angelo Lloyd. He attempted the three, but that one was off and rebounded by Montana. As now, here we go. It's going to be a shot. Looked like he wanted it. Won't take it. Instead, he's going to play some hot potato and now pass it over. Now the wings working their way in. Driving gets it. Very good shot. And the spin on that one was to be observed, as it did not hit in the spot where you would have assumed it would have gone in. Now here's Mitch Brizzy once again at the top of the perimeter. And a quick pass from the hands of Dawson into Brizzy. Will take 2 points and give them right back to the Cats.
That was a bullet.
That it was, as here's Tot. You know, you love to see those bailout passes. They really are one of the most underrated moves in basketball. Now here on the other end, Montana State once again doing their thing. Ball's going to be lost, and Seth Dawson's going to take control. Moving in on the right side. He's got Brizzy to his left. Won't use the screen. Instead, he's going to attack individually. Now coming in against Tot. He's got the size difference. He's going to come in. Was looking to force the mismatch, but was unable to make it past him, trying to post up. Now Angelo Lloyd with the ball in hand, working here on the perimeter. He's a dangerous man with that ball in his hands. He drives up and gets it to go. The floater from Angelo Lloyd. Wow, what a play. And just like that, the tides turn just the slightest bit as Central Washington is now only trailing by 3. Passes to Richmond, who drives now, and he's going to attempt a sneaky pass, but it's Mitch Brizzy bringing the ball back in. That's right, Jackson, the Dikembe Mutombo, no. As on the other end is going to be a foul. It appears a timeout's going to be called. And with that, we're going to take 1-2 and be back in just a moment here, not only on the 88.1 The Berg live stream, but also on the Central Washington University Athletics live stream. 88.1 The Berg, your Music Central, as well as the Central Washington University Athletics live stream. Folks, we are returning to the action. We've got about 10 and a half minutes remaining in this game. Central Washington University trails by 3, but the momentum has been swinging in their favor thanks to some great plays, not only by Angelo Lloyd, but by a variety of different Wildcats. Now we look to see if they're able to do anything to keep their momentum moving in their favor as we look towards the end of this matchup. It'll be Bradley Swilly, the inbounder for the Wildcats, coming out of the break. Thank you for tuning in, folks. This is Ryan Gildersleeve, your play-by-play broadcaster, as well as my color commentator, Jackson Roberts, on the call for this first conference matchup of the home season. Now here's Seth Dawson tossing out left to Angelo Lloyd, back to him. And now some movement on the court. As here's Seth Dawson, he drives his way up, gives it to Jeanette. Jeanette now looking for somebody. He's going to find Dawson going up and over Todd. Now here's Dawson driving in. He's got Jeanette open on the perimeter. Now he's going to drive, look for the points by himself. Won't be able to get it, but he is going to have a foul called. And so just like that, it'll be the second foul called in the second half against Montana State Billings. Central Washington with 4 against themselves.
I was going to say, I was waiting for one to come our way, a foul.
Right.
Like to see them blow the whistle there. That was some pretty hard contact. Send him to the floor.
As it's going to be Seth Dawson putting up some shots from the charity stripe. Seth Dawson so far on the season shooting about 76% from the line.
Looks like he missed the first one.
That he did. So not necessarily what you want to seek from the charity stripe. Of course, it's called the charity stripe for a reason. And now the second free throw is up, and he won't be able to hit on either of them. So the Wildcats are going to suffer a lost opportunity on a play which could have brought them back within 1 point. It'll be number 3, Daniel Moody, the inbounder for Montana State, as he tosses it into Richardson.
Wildcats are the full court press right now.
And now here's Todd. Todd bringing his way up. I do like that defensive strategy by the Wildcats, trying to force some more pressure. But this one's going to find its way onto the painted area. A foul is called on that, which, of course, there is a very different angle for the referee there. But from our angle,
that's pretty soft.
Yeah, definitely did not look like the proper call there. We'll keep to ourselves as it's going to be Montana State shooting from the line once again, the fifth time that a foul has been committed by the Wildcats this half.
This is Richardson shooting the 29% free throw shooter. Makes that one, though.
He's been great from the free throw line so far tonight, which makes you think he may have been sandbagging us with those prior stats, though I would hope that that wasn't on the forefront of his mind. He now attempts the second shot, and listen to that crowd. He misses up and off the back iron. And so just like that, the Wildcats keep themselves within striking distance. Not on one drive, but a two-drive separation isn't necessarily too unheard of for the Wildcats. As here's Colby Jeanette with the ball in hand. He's going to work against Richardson as he now gives it over to Seth Dawson. Dawson has Jeanette outright, not going to use him, instead giving it to Swilly, who puts up the shot and gets that to go. So now cuts the lead down to 2, and we'll see how Montana is able to answer back. Bradley Swilly guarding the primary ball handler for Montana. He's going to head out right. Now it's passed out to the top of the key. And once again, Montana operating from the perimeter. They've really done a good job of driving onto the interior and trying to get easy shots when they have the opportunity to. As now here's the shot put up and a fadeaway two-pointer. This one not going to land as opposed to the last one that we saw. But 2 points are going to fall. And what was a quite simple shot, Samad Hector just unable to make it there in time following the previous play. And now here's Angelo Lloyd, ball in hand. He's going to toss this one over to Seth Dawson. Dawson wanted it, won't take it, gives it to Swilly. Swilly wants it, won't be able to convert on it. And Samad Hector just fingertips away from the rebound as Montana takes back over. Passes over, here are the Yellow Jackets driving. Here's the shot put up, and Moody's going to get the and one. So a heartbreaking play there, as you could just about feel the hearts drop in the gym as that one falls in.
Still a lot of time left, though. 8.5 minutes, only down by 6. Could be 7 here, but it is manageable.
That it is. I mean, nothing is out of the realm of possibility, specifically with this Wildcat team. And we wait for the free throw to be put up as whistles will blow.
Moody's calling for something.
Moody is calling for something, and it appears that he just lost his shot. Moody loses his free throw. And Central Washington retakes possession of the basketball in a crucial moment. So, ladies and gentlemen, that could turn out to be what turned this game from the moment, or excuse me, from the favor of Montana to Central Washington, as they lose a critical shot, which would have put them to 4 points, or excuse me, just about 4 drives away, as Montana is going to take away all of that excitement with a quick steal. Here's Moody on the other end. One would have to assume that he's quite fired up. He's going to shoot it out to Famous left hand. Here's Famous left hand back out to Moody. Moody working against Colby Jeanette. Puts up the shot. Won't be able to get it to go. Though it's rebounded by Tott. Tott out to left hand. Left hand is back out. And they toss it back onto the interior with Moody. Moody's going to use his body properly and get that shot to go. So Central Washington now trails by 8 points. And it is Seth Dawson working against his defender before kicking it out to Samad Hector. Hector now is going to dish to Jeanette, who will then return the favor over to Clark. Clark to McNeil. McNeil now to Jeanette. Jeanette's got an opportunity. He's going to take it, and he's not going to be able to capitalize on the first opportunity. And the second, though an athletic play to say the least, it's not going to fall. And that appears that a technical foul has just been called against Montana State Billings. So a technical foul is called. It'll be called against Moody, who just lost the free throw. So it seems getting a bit chippy are the Yellow Jackets, as they have just put themselves in quite the uncomfortable situation, still leading by 8 points. But if Central Washington can capitalize on these frankly boneheaded decisions, then this should be an easy reclaiming of some momentum for your Wildcat basketball team.
It looks like Angelo Lloyd may be checking in as well. Looks like he just went and confirmed to the desk.
And like we've talked about throughout the course of this game, he is definitely an X factor for this Wildcat team. If you don't have anybody putting up points, you're going to have opportunities for Angelo Lloyd. And the numbers show you he is likely to convert whenever he gets an opportunity. Well, so with that being said, you know, our Central Washington fans have really packed this building out. Of course, this is the first time that we've really gotten to see a regular season conference matchup and the attendance that that'll bring this season. Jackson, I'm just wondering, what are you thinking, checking out the atmosphere that we've got brought to the pavilion here tonight?
Well, I like the new student section involved, too. That was a cool touch added, but it's just a beautiful center in here. It's just awesome. A lot of stands. I hope that we can get more fans to completely pack it out at some point this year, but it's a good showing tonight for sure.
And one would hope. I mean, the attendance definitely does tend to fluctuate. But Central Washington, I will say, has statistically, if you look at the numbers, held a very large attendance advantage over their GNAC opponents. So it's Angelo Lloyd shooting the free throw off of the technical foul. He's going to convert, so a free point for the Wildcats. He's going to shoot one more. Angelo Lloyd, second shot. And he's going to knock it down. So there's the two shots. The Wildcats should still have possession of the basketball, if I'm not mistaken.
And knocking down free throws for Angelo Lloyd is nothing new to him. He's 94% on the season, so he can knock him down pretty easy.
As it appears that a miscommunication on my own sake will have Montana State Billings having possession of the basketball. So here's Tott working against working against Angelo Lloyd. He's going to find this one out left. Now working on the perimeter. And the ball is tossed in. They're going to look for a post opportunity here against Samad Hector. Not the guy that you want to challenge. He shows it there. And yet another foul is called. So no action apparently is allowed in the paint if you are Central Washington. That's the third foul against Samad Hector so far in this game.
Yeah, it's Ajinaku who got quote-unquote fouled. He's 78 on the season shooting, so he can make them, but hopefully might miss a couple here. Keep it a six-point game, otherwise it might be 7 or 8.
As now the shot coming from the free throw line will fall. That's going to push the lead for the opposition up to 7. And it'll also, coincidentally, be his 7th point of the game as he now looks to push both of those totals up to 8. You can hear the crowd getting loud. Here it is, folks. As the shot will fall, and just like that, we fall behind by 8 points. Substitutions here for Montana State. Central Washington will run the same lineup here. Jordan Clark receives the inbound from Angelo Lloyd, and now he's going to give it right back to him. Lloyd now tossing to the corner with Jeanette. Jeanette's going to move it around, give it back to Lloyd. Lloyd being double-teamed, over to Jeanette. Jeanette now to Swilly, or excuse me, to Lloyd. Lloyd puts up the shot, unable to get it to go. And it's rebounded now by Montana, and here comes Famous Left Hand. Famous Left Hand moving out left. He banks the pass to Tott. Tott now back on over, and it's in the hand of Left Hand once again. He's going to toss to the inside, and that ball almost stolen, but instead they're going to retain possession. Three-pointer put up from the outside, missed. Second chance points will fall. Wildcats now trailing by double digits for the first time in this game. Samad Hector, ball in hand for the Cats. He passes over to Jordan Clark. Clark doesn't take the shot, instead will retreat just slightly, looking for something here. He's got Samad Hector bringing the screen. He's going to use it. Now he's got Hector in the post. Puts up a shot of his own, though, and he gets it to go. So Jordan Clark, we've been able to see, he works in that pick and roll very well. He's a pick and roll specialist, to say the least, as Montana State not going to succumb to the full court press. And here they come once more. I believe this is Richardson who passes out to Tott. It is Richmond, as now... Here is Left Hand with the ball in hand, driving onto the painted area. Colby Jeanette is there, and it appeared that a travel was called, though I may have been mistaken there.
They called it on the floor is what it looks like before he went up with the shot. So it's going to be Montana State's ball on the side, I think.
Foul against Colby Jeanette is going to be the call that they end up solidifying. Not what you want to see at all. And just like that, it is the bonus for the Montana State Yellow Jackets.
Yep. Ajinaku back at the line.
And he's going to get that one to go. So they push the lead up to 9.
Lucky for us, basketball is a game of runs. So if the Wildcats can get one going and just play some solid defense and get some offense going, we could easily get back into this game. 5 minutes, 50 seconds left. There's some time.
As now another free throw will be attempted. And it will land. So back to a 10-point total separating these two squads. We've got 5 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in this game, as now Jordan Clark with the ball in hand, scouring the court, looking for an open man. He's going to have the screen from Brizzy. He's going to toss over to McNeil. McNeil now to Angelo Lloyd. A lot of slashers on the court for the Cats, and a foul is called. A great job of pulling that one for Angelo Lloyd. Definitely did a good job of drawing the foul, and it'll be the fourth to go against Montana State Billings in the second half.
That one called on the floor. It's going to be Jordan Clark inbounding the ball here.
Now it's Angelo Lloyd, the recipient of the inbound. He's going to toss over, and now driving is Cameron McNeil. Takes the step back, tosses to Brizzy. Brizzy back to McNeil. Cameron McNeil, of course, last year's leading scorer for the Wildcats. Working against his defender, he kicks out to Angelo Lloyd. Here comes Lloyd. Lloyd will not be able to put up a shot. Instead, gets it to McNeil, who puts up a three. This one is up and off, though. Rebounded offensively by Colby Jeanette, and this one will find its way out of bounds. Wildcat basketball. Jalen Tott will be arguing just a bit with the referee, which is quite interesting. I mean, as you quite obviously knocked that one out of bounds and have already suffered a technical foul, if it were me, I would be talking about as much as a man alone in the woods.
I was going to say, I'll take another technical. It's a couple free throws, the possession. I'll take it.
And Jordan Clark, the inbounder for the Wildcats here, he's going to quickly toss it up and in to Mitch Brizzy. Now, Clark, ball in hand once more. He works against Tott, takes the screen from Brizzy, moving out right. Now towards the top of the key, gives it to McNeil. A great pass, and Brizzy's going to score. So that's 2 to the Cats, 8-point lead for the Yellow Jackets.
Another bullet for McNeil.
That it was. He's just a great passer, so gifted in finding those guys that just have the slightest sliver of an opportunity. Now Tott, ball in hand. He's going to toss his one over to Famous Left Foot, who tries to pull a foul there. It's unsuccessful, and Jalo Lloyd is going to get this one to go. But no more. And I was going to say, no time for excitement, but a timeout is going to be called, and we'll take one, too. Be back in just a few moments here on here on 88.1 The Berg, your music central, as well as Central Washington University's athletics live stream.
88.1 The Berg would like...
88.1 The Berg, your Music Central, as well as the Central Washington University Athletics live stream. Folks, we are in the midst of a heated one. A six-point total separates the Wildcats from the Yellow Jackets. The Yellow Jackets have obtained the bonus as the Wildcats have committed eight fouls in the half. We are under 5 minutes remaining, sitting exactly at 4 minutes and 33 seconds. And let me tell you, Jackson, this has been a tough game to watch for a variety of reasons. But if this Wildcat team can continue to be as gracefully aggressive as they were on these last couple of drives, we might have some hope left in us in these last 4 minutes.
Well, like I said earlier, it's a game of runs. We're on a 4-0 run right now. So if we're able to just continue playing the defense that we've played in the last couple minutes, and whether we get to the foul line, we take some good jumpers. I like Jordan Clark in the pick and roll. Just anything to get some points up on the board right now. We're still down six, so got to get some up.
As now it'll be the inbound for Montana State Billings. The full court press a little bit more aggressive this time, but it's going to cause a situation where it's an immediate turnover. The full court press causes problems not in the full court, but on the side where it matters. So Central Washington takes back over and has a chance to do something big here. Jordan Clark with the ball in hand. Central Washington has been able to capitalize on a number of Montana State mistakes so far. Can this drive be another one of those opportunities? Now, Brizzy to McNeil. McNeil now driving to his left. Coming into the painted area, he's blocked. And Cameron McNeil going to retain possession. He gives it over to Brizzy, to Clark for three. This one is up and off. Rebounded now by Tott. Not where you want to pull from, where you desperately need points. As here's Tott faced up against Angelo Lloyd. Lloyd now is going to poke this ball loose. Brizzy not going to be able to bring it in, though. And the pass to the corner will result in an easy shot for famous left hand, scoring his third points of the night so far. As now, the Wildcats on the other end, Jordan Clark with it, now over to Colby Jeanette. Jeanette drives, loses the ball. So another turnover for the Wildcats costs them what are crucial points at this point in the game. 3.5 remaining. Tott leisurely strolling around, looking to kill some time and keep points on the board for Montana State. Tossed over a couple of times. Here's left hand driving against Jeanette, tossing out to Tott. Jalen Tott with the ball in hand. He works now against Angelo Lloyd. Now he's sitting still at the top of the key. He loses it for a second. Mitch Brizzy closes out on the perimeter, and just like that, Central still keeping the 8 point separation intact. As here's Jordan Clark moving out right, now heads back left against the screen. He's going to toss out to Angelo Lloyd, who shoots the three. This one is up and off, though, and rebounded once again from Montana State Billings. So unable to get a big shot to land are the Wildcats, who have just been really in. They have been unable to score from beyond the perimeter, to put it nicely. As here are Montana State and the Yellow Jackets trying to do something. As that's Moody tossing over to Tott. Tott puts up the shot on the interior. And just like that, another foul called against the Wildcats. Their ninth of the half.
Well, coming out of that timeout, I thought we may have drawn up some better plays or something. We came out with a couple turnovers and a couple deep threes that just have not seemed to be ideal looks for us. Like we said earlier, we can hit the threes if we need to most of the time, but tonight it has not been the case. I believe we've had one or two three-pointers all night.
And you know, one thing that I think needs to be focused on just a slight bit is the absence of the ball in Samad Hector's hands. Samad Hector is an absolutely gifted scorer, and when his only opportunities of the game are coming when you pass it to him in the post, you're not giving him an opportunity to play to the full extent of his game. He's the leading scorer on this team for a reason, and he has severely been misused in this matchup, if you do ask for my own opinion. Now, it is not my opinion that matters here. It is the game itself, as Central Washington trails by 8 points, and we'll see what they're able to come out of the timeout playing. I mean, really, there's so many different things that they could adjust to make it happen, but I think it all starts with the players that you put back out on the court. I like the way that we were moving with practically all slashers, but the absence of Samad Hector is not one that we can afford right now. And we'll see how they come out of the timeout as the whistles blow and they break the huddle.
I hope Hector checks in here. It looks like he is going to check in. That's a good sight for us.
That's exactly what we need. He's a big body. He moves fast. He's a strong guy. Wherever you've got him, he's going to be an asset. I'm not exactly sure why he hasn't been used more tonight. But with that being said, of course, he is in line to check into this game after the first free throw is put up. So it'll be Jalen Tott. Jackson, what has Tott looked like from the free throw line this season?
78% and just rose it a little bit on that shot. He makes that one.
Yeah, he will, as now he's got a second opportunity. It'll be Mitch Brizzy coming out of the game for Samad Hector, which is an interesting move with the court that we've currently got out there. As here's the shot. Jalen Tott is going to hit both of his free throws, and that's going to extend the lead to 15 for Montana State. That's going to extend the lead to 10. My apologies. As now here's Jordan Clark. Ball in hand, working against Tott. He's going to toss to McNeil. McNeil the mid-range. He's not going to hit, and that's going to be Montana State ball. 2 minutes remaining in this game, and Central Washington desperately needs something to happen here. They move it around. Here's Moody handing the ball off, and now it's tossed back over to Richmond. Richmond's going to hand it off to famous left hand, back to Tott. And there's a foul called on the court. It appears that it's going to be called against Central Washington, who now have 10 fouls in the half, an atrocious number.
Just got to play with better discipline on defense. Also, just got to, it depends on your refs as well, of course, but you can't always use the refs as an excuse. You just got to play with better discipline.
As now, the free throw shooter is going to be Richmond. Here's the first. It will fall. 11-point lead for Montana State Billings. Bradley Swilly in the game for Cameron McNeil. As we await the second free throw, 1:55 remaining in this game once this free throw is shot. This one is up and in. So just like that, it's a 12-point lead for Montana State Billings as the Wildcats look to cut that down with what should be a crucial drive. Here's Bradley Swilly, ball in hand. He drives, goes for the fadeaway. Not the shot that you want to be taking. Need to find an open look. But they need to use the clock to their advantage, so you have to keep that in mind, as now it is Tott once again working on the other end. If you're Montana State, you have to imagine that your goal is just to hold on to the ball as long as possible, as a timeout is going to be called by Montana State, or so it appears. Which is quite the interesting situation.
I was thinking that too.
What we were actively speaking on, but yeah, not what you necessarily want to see.
Well, with those last free throws from Richmond, he ties his team high 12 points right now. I believe it's Richmond and it is Richmond and Richardson, both at 12 points.
So the Riches, yep, definitely doing their job here tonight for the Yellow Jackets. Not where you want to be if you are Central Washington, but as the huddle breaks, we get ready to see how they are going to adjust their game style coming out of the break.
At this point, this is where we have to start shooting some threes. It hasn't worked for us all night, but if we want to get back into this game, we need a clutch three as well as some clutch defense right now.
Yeah, defense is definitely going to be a big factor in these final 1.5 minutes. The time that we have is very valuable here as the ball is going to be tossed in. And immediately, triple teaming. It's a bit interesting. That should be another technical foul. I don't understand why it is that Montana State Billings is getting away with, frankly, trashing not only the court that they are playing on, but the referees as well. A technical foul has already been issued, but a second one should have been issued there. I cannot believe the absolute lack of not only camaraderie, but sportsmanship by Montana State Billings tonight.
Yeah, the refs look like they're discussing something. I don't know if they're going to call a tech. It does not look like it.
So what a game that we have witnessed here tonight. Folks, if you were here in attendance, you would see that there are a lot of angles to what game we have been watching tonight. And depending on where you are, it's a completely different game from all angles. Folks, what a game we have watched, and I don't want to repeat myself too much further, but there's just only so much you can say to describe a matchup like this.
Well, yeah, of course, first home game, conference play home game of the season, and you knew there was going to be intensity, but just wish it was a little bit of a closer score right now, coming down to the final minute and a half, just hoping our losing streak does not go away.
Exactly. You know, it's just, it's one of those things where not only did the Wildcat men's team, but the Lady Cat team as well come into this game, both riding extensive winning streaks, the women's team more so than the men. But I would say a four-game win streak is nothing to scoff at, especially when you play in a league with such little competition, or excuse me, and in that, I mean not that the opposing teams are bad. I mean that, you know, you don't really get to play a whole lot of teams. So where you do get to play, you might as well play your heart out, which is what the Wildcats have done, just unable to get anything going really tonight against Montana State Billings in what has been a defensive showdown. As they move it around a little bit, here's Famous left hand trying to see if he can put some wording behind that name. Now driving and missing the layup is going to be Richmond, but the second chance points go. Your Wildcats trail by 14 points as Jordan Clark scrolls out left, gives it to Swilly. Swilly now to Jeanette. Jeanette wants a shot, won't take it. Instead kicks to Clark. Clark's going to take the three, and he's going to miss. This one will be rebounded by, it appears that there's quite a bit of a skirmish as it's tossed out to Swilly for three, and this one is off. Then it's rebounded by Angelo Lloyd. He puts up the shot and he's fouled, unable to get it to go. And folks, this has just been one of the more scrappy games that you could imagine between these two teams. They're rosters that are built to compete, but this is not necessarily the way that one could have foreshadowed it happening.
Yeah, Central's getting desperate now. Bodies are flying all over the place. That was a hard-fought loose ball that I think Jeanette came up with, so that was good hustle by him. Just unfortunately couldn't make the three.
As Jordan Clark will be the inbounder for the Wildcats, tossing this one up to Cameron McNeil. McNeil now for three, and this one will not fall.
Just no luck.
The Wildcats still unable to connect from beyond the three-point line, which really has cost them this game. As the whistles blow on the court, and we'll see how they will call this one. It appears that it's a foul against Bradley Swilly. So Bradley Swilly picks up his first foul of the game. The Wildcats, their 11th.
And it's going to be Richmond back at the line. He's had quite a bit of free throws. Has an opportunity to become his team's leading scorer tonight.
As we await to see if he is able to put a couple more points here up on the board. He'll miss the first one, which correlates to his statistics, if I do remember correctly.
Richmond is the 84% free throw shooter. It was Richardson.
Okay. So operating along a bit different waters here, as he will nail the second one, so keeping that free throw percentage away from his teammate. As here comes Central Washington, ball in the hands of Cameron McNeil, scrolling out right. He's got the screen from Samad. Back to Samad Hector for three, and he's going to be unable to connect. So just like that, there's no shot clock remaining. That's going to do it for this game. Your Central Washington Wildcats lose to Montana State Billings by a score of 59-74. And in the opening day of conference games for both of our Wildcat teams, we will suffer losses. Ladies and gentlemen, we are very thankful to have had you tune into our broadcast today. I, of course, was your play-by-play broadcaster, Ryan Gildersleeve, alongside Jackson Roberts on the call for this men's game. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to jump straight into our little post-game report right now. And there's not a whole lot to say. This is the simple facts. Central Washington drops the game by 15 points due to their inability to strike from beyond the three-point line. A lot of missed opportunities, a lot of wide-open shots they were unable to connect on. It seemed like the confidence was not there coming out of the second half, and it showed on the scoreboard. I mean, at half, we had a one-point separation coming in now. That point differential shifted, and it was 14 points better for Montana State Billings in the second half than Central Washington. Folks, one consistent strand throughout not only this game, but the women's game earlier today. The Wildcats Wildcats need some glue on their hands. They need something to be able to keep the ball in their possession. Turnovers are going to be the absolute downfall of this team if they're unable to reel it back in sometime soon. With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, this is a wonderful Wildcat basketball team, and they were able to show a whole lot of improvement over last season for our returning Wildcats, and they were able to make a statement for themselves for the most part if you are a new Wildcat. But like we said, it's a tough game to recap, as when your team falls, it's not necessarily what you'd like to see. But Jackson, was there anything you picked up on in this game that you think maybe swung it one way or another?
Second half offense, we said during halftime report that we need to get the offense rolling, getting a groove. We said it was 28 points at halftime, I believe. And so we came out and only scored, I believe, as 31 points. So that's only a little bit more, three more points than what we had in the first half. And that is not what we needed. We needed more three-pointers that were actually going to fall. We were taking some deep three-pointers in the late part of the game, but I just think we need to do a better job at using our looks to our advantage. I liked what we were doing, like I said, many times. Jordan Clark, pick and roll with him when he just pick and pop, and then he can just shoot it from the free throw line jumper, and he had it. Seemed like he had it pretty well. But I guess just clean it up on offense, realize the mistakes that we made of just pulling shots that were not too high percentage.
Exactly. And Jackson, I'd like to thank you for being on the broadcast staff for today. It was great being able to call the game with you folks. If you are looking for your next Central Washington basketball game, you're not going to have to wait long, as this Saturday, Seattle Pacific University comes to town to take on Central Washington. The women's game will kick things off Saturday with a start time of, I believe, sitting around 4 o'clock, and then the men's game directly following. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning into our broadcast tonight. For Ryan Gildersleeve, Jackson Roberts, 88.1 The Berg, and the Central Washington University Athletics live stream, we are signing off.
The Berg would like to thank our